Engines are designed for a certain viscosity of fuels. For biofuels to be considered a drop-in fuel, they must perform similar to petroleum-based fuels. Viscosity is the degree of a material's resistance to flow. Low viscous materials flow quickly like water, and highly viscous materials flow slowly like honey. Kinematic viscosity is the ratio of absolute viscosity divided by the fluid density, which is measured in centistokes or millimeters squared per second. Kinematic viscosity is more relevant when we consider flow behavior. Biodiesel typically has a slightly higher kinematic viscosity when compared with petroleum diesel, around 4.5 centistokes for biodiesel and 3 centistokes for number 2 diesel. The acceptable viscosity range for biodiesel, according to ASTM D6751, is between 1.9 and 6.0 millimeters squared per second. The kinematic viscosity upper limit for biodiesel is higher than the upper limit for normal diesel fuel, which is 4.1 millimeters squared per second. Low viscosity fuel can leak through seals, whereas high viscosity fuel is difficult to pump and can have issues with atomization, which can lead to poor combustion and increased harmful emissions. Temperature and feedstocks used for biodiesel affect kinematic viscosity. The kinematic viscosity value of biodiesel and diesel decreases with an increase in temperature. Petroleum diesel and biodiesel have similar rates when comparing kinematic viscosity to temperature. Even though the rates are similar, there is a greater difference at lower temperatures between biodiesel and petroleum diesel. By blending biodiesel with petroleum diesel, the blended fuel has a reduced kinematic viscosity compared to pure biodiesel. Blended biodiesel is recommended in colder temperatures.
Clean the viscometer using suitable solvents and by passing clean, dry, filtered air through the instrument to remove the final traces of solvents. To charge the sample into the viscometer, invert the instrument and apply suction to the large tube, immersing the small tube in the liquid sample, and draw the liquid to the second mark. Wipe clean and turn the instrument to its normal vertical position. Place the viscometer into the holder and insert it into the constant temperature bath, ensuring that it's aligned vertically. Allow approximately 10 minutes for the sample to come to the bath temperature at 40 degrees C and 15 minutes at 100 degrees C. Apply suction to the small tube or pressure to the large tube and draw the liquid slightly above the top mark. To measure the efflux time, allow the liquid sample to flow freely down past the second mark, measuring the time for the meniscus to pass between the marks. Calculate the kinematic viscosity in millimeters squared per second, or in centistokes, of the sample by multiplying the efflux time in seconds by the viscometer constant. Repeat the test and calculate the kinematic viscosity again. Average the values to report the kinematic viscosity of the tested fuel.
Visit our website at www.biodieseleducation.org for more information. We're on Facebook and Twitter, too.